Good afternoon, all. This is Fatty Hemsey, or should I say early good evening? It's about 5:12 p.m. on Wednesday, the 16th of February. As you know, this week is option expiration week. And again, we were chatting a little bit before about we're happy that we're doing these in the afternoon. It's a little bit easier than early in the morning. And also, we'll get a chance to post-process this. If it goes a little bit longer, it takes long. We always put it here on the YouTube. Try and do this in the morning with trades coming in, options, option trades. You know, futures are moving. It's quite a bit. As you know, we only trade derivative. We do not trade stocks. We do stock options. We do ETF options. And, of course, a lot of futures. Time becomes of essence. So, housekeeping, very, very simple. We had two webinars yesterday. One was for a special group of people coming in as affiliates from one of the websites that we worked with before, and they feel that with the product we're doing with their day trading systems, yeah, fits their profile. Good thing is that it takes your emotions out. It's a system that runs. You can decide to follow it or not follow it, but bottom line is it's profitable to about 7x to 8x over a 1 year period. So, you know, and the requirement is like 18, it's 14,000. Plus a buffer for the first few months, and you take the buffer out. But doing 7x, so it gives you 7 times 14. But 70 is about, it's about 100,000 a year, 114,000. It's about 7x. It takes 2 hours a day. It uses it in queue. The manual is extensive, you'll see. It's got about like 18 exits for various kinds of situations, both for your money management, for trading, and also a straight profit target, you know, as a limit order, and time stop too. It stops at a certain time. We have a lot of wall now that we haven't had before early on. So, and we can't keep on opening it up. We can't just keep giving you some more room. The problem is, you know, the wall we have now, actually, you get some, I don't know if you've noticed it or not. For example, an NQ. ES follows it too. There's a high correlation. It trades compressed, but let's say, you know, and we are trying to game it around the first 15, 20 minutes. It gets compressed to like 40 minutes. Once you get out of our window, that the signal is not going to come. We're not going to engage. Volatility explodes even further. I'm saying it becomes directional. So there's less sausage, more directional, up or down, and that becomes the trend. And by then, the system is not trading. So we're looking at that slightly, but overall, I mean, in Z contract, he did 50 grand. Same amount of money in 3 months. It's just massive, massive. So why? Just different texture. The texture's not going to be constant. In May of last year, 1 week lost every single day. So it was five losers in a row, which we don't have. Maybe it wasn't repeated. So it happens. That's the thing about system trading. You got to stick to it. You got to stick to good and bad, because the good days will come, but other times it's going to shake you. So, yeah, 4.3 is here. We had launched 4.2. Matter of fact, 4.2 is posted here. 4.3 will go into the chat room tomorrow. The elite package, which is the other trade that you run yourself with TradeStation, that will be a week from now. So we will be posting all of those, updating those over the weekend. 4.3 is a slightly better, it's more robust. And then we'll set up another section there. I use from 4.2 on, we're going to be doing tick by tick back testing, which means that each tick is preserved. So it comes to the machine as if you're streaming, as if you have a DVR, except now it's your trade session and your account. So as the trade comes in, it executes it. Before it was 3 minute bars. Problem with 3 minute bars that you get. Where every boy get open, high, low, close. Well, what order they came in, we don't know. Okay. And was there enough volume there to execute your trade? Now, we're trading small. NQ is 3. That's no problem. But you have option to run MNQ at the early stages just to comfort yourself as you go to simulator trading, MNQ, and then NQ. Well, on MNQ, the micro, you can trade the same amount. That means you can go to 30 MNQ, which is 3 NQ, because you have an option. Well, then that becomes a volume issue too. Was there enough volume when that price came in? You see what I'm saying? So it's very crucial to have tick by tick testing. The problem with that, and we also post the TTM, which is trailing 12 months. That's how hedge funds look at things. The last 12 months, what they do, that becomes a monster problem. You can imagine, as I was mentioning just before we started, what the tick by tick volume will be for 12 months. It's huge, especially the markets we have now. And this is the 4.2. You can see what the results are. These were posted, I believe, last week or week before. As 4.2 came, we began talking about plus 4.3 is going to be. But I didn't stop. I said, let's do 4.2 because we don't know where 4.3 is going to be. And yesterday, we had an issue with TradeStation on the execution part, not the code. And that's really the challenges we have noticed. I'm an indicator writer. I'm not a system writer. So I have a small part in this. I've hired a person to do the programming for me. But I'm learning a lot from him. I'm realizing it's not what you know about writing a system. It's how TradeStation executes on the other side in Chicago. If you don't understand that, you're going to have a hodgepodge. You're going to have a soup that does not resemble reality in your backtesting. And therefore, when you go live, which we've been doing it since like October 7th, you're going to have very, very unexpected results. Now, I'm not saying we haven't had any. There were a couple of the three indicators, like Dennis Buffalo will attest to that. Of the three, he's very alert and very sharp in there. Even though from different time zone, he is there like a hawk. You've seen like three orders of NQ go out. We get filled on two. It's simply software ticking in. Now, you always have a chance to, overwrite that. There's no question. We have a dome open. We give you the setup way to go that you know what you should be doing if you need to go manual. Okay. And it's been good. It's a pretty decent journey. As I promised, I said day one, we're going to show you how this development is done. I said, I don't know it myself either. I'll be a student just like you, but it'll be a journey. And one day you may want to write your own system. Why not? My mom always said, you can't take your brain with you either. So if you pass on something you know to other people, you're living through them long after you're gone. So that's the purpose. So anyhow, 4.3 will be up tomorrow in the chat room. So the mic message right now is the two lead members who are present here. And of course, we'll look at this video later. The lead members are the ones who run it themselves. And they're in the chat room. Just remember, just like before, you're going to be one version behind. Why? We got right in the chat room in a control environment before I could send it out to you and let you mess up your account. Yeah, that's a downside. You have to take, you can't always look at things with rosy glasses. Think about, you can't always be on offensive. Think about the defense too. So, anyway, that's things on our target. The other one is the last time you have the webinars, we also showed our Gamma Ladder. Gamma Ladder allows you to load a multi, it doesn't seem useful for everybody. But if you have multi-account trading going on, it allows you to automatically to fill the dome, the depth of the market, the matrix, as Tracy calls it, of your orders in an orderly manner with one click. And does entries and exits. It also does what's called, it's equivalent of chandelier stops, if you're familiar with that. That is, as you go high, and you're making your money, you have an equity going on, it looks into like a chandelier underneath the price to grab any pullback as adjusted by volatility. Yeah. Very interesting stuff. A lot of code. A lot of code. As I will show it to you on our CI in here, which is very new to you, very, very familiar with all you guys. Nothing new. Been there since 2002. I keep on bringing it up because I've done an account, I remember. Nine lines of code in ELD. ELD is easy language. So in nine of code, we do CI, which is like fifth generation moment of indicator. Smash everything else out there. RSI, Williams R, MACD, all those are just the level. But when CI came in, that's nine lines of code. There are 4.2 system is 680 lines. The gamma ladder is over 1,000. It's almost 1,100 lines. Yeah. The bot is actually you're adding your own bot. Like your own buy and sell. This is a very sophisticated buy and sell. It's about 1,100 lines of code. And tremendous work. It's gone in since 6th of December. As a matter of fact, I really didn't understand much of the holidays because I was so involved with this one. So, anyhow, let's go to our first batch here, which is Econ Calendar. Don't need to tell you what's going on. It's called inflation. Why? First, two things. First of all, Anchor was too low, the benchmark. We were too bad last year. We were deflation last year. Go look at the data. It's not a politics. It's a reality. Let's deal with reality. If not, we're going to keep it pounding in your head. It's going to be that simple. Yeah. And that's one. Two is that the numbers are very strong now. The recovery is fast. We have shortages. We have supply chains. The people were not at work. They have to come back. And not everything is smoothly integrated. We were also on just-in-time delivery. When you have a pandemic, it shows just-in-time delivery is a bunch of BS. It's not going to work. Of course, we've seen the results of that. And retail is not stopping. You saw retail sales today. That was yesterday, I guess. No, I'm sorry. Why am I thinking? This stuff is tomorrow, yeah. Retail sales came in today. Fairly strong. And that's helping the inflation up. So, look at what the consensus was, okay, and prior, look where we came in. If you had any doubt that the variable Jerome Powell is going to tighten, the deal is sealed. It's a done deal. And remember, and don't get fooled today. Today, here's what happened in the futures there. This is when the minutes came. But this is a January meeting. This is before the non-farm, before January, that came in February 4th, I believe. It's before the CPI, PPI. They didn't have that. So this is just juicing up the system. I will not be surprised if they do intermeeting. Last one was video conference. Why can't they just turn on the video conference? Intermeeting and say, hey, guys. Like Ben Bernanke did before. I don't know about Yellen, but I don't know. Back then, I don't think we had anything like that going on with Greenspan. I'm not sure Greenspan can use a phone. I don't know. It's fossil. It's from another age, you know. It's from dinosaur age. But they did. I remember Bernanke had easing at 9 o'clock one day on a Friday before expiration, and it was summertime. I think it was August of 2007, I forget, or maybe September, right after Labor Day. I don't know. It was right at I think August would be reasonable. He had been there like 6 months, a year, whatever. He eased it must have been 2007. Yes. Because 2006 things were kind of normal. It was 2007 that we had some trouble, especially with like Countrywide. So they eased right before option expiration. And we had like a 50 handle move on the ES in one bar. This poor market makers, they never made it to work. There was no business left. You're coming in pretty much delta neutral. And you're watching your ROI, except on a right over to SIBO, you find that the scale changed. So it was. I thought it was data error, I swear. I just sat down. This is LA. I just sat down 6 in the morning with my coffee. Someone walked to my desk, my training desk. I work from home. I've done that for years. Sat in there, and I went for the phone automatic call trade session, checking to see if the data is a data error. I'm hitting control R and the data's not changing. And one guy laughed and says, what time is it over there? And I said, 6 in the morning. He goes, have more coffee. That was a Fed chairman. Just change rates. There was no data. So people got fried. I would do, as a matter of fact, this was a question I asked me last night in one of the webinars, which a bunch of highly educated PhDs from both East Coast and West Coast saying, a couple of them are very good. One by a student of Fisher Black of Black-Scholes model. at MIT. He had nuclear engineering from MIT. He asked me, he said, what's your opinion? I said, well, I don't have it. I'm an economist. But if you get in the past, I mean, it'd be a Fed watcher, but not an educated one. Not in that realm. But I said, I would do two 50-50s. I want full basis point by March. And they just like unraveled. It was Zoom. I could see the other pictures. They're just like, what? I said, yeah, I would pick up the phone, do a phone meeting, 50% now, 50%, 50 basis point now, 50 basis point in March. Because you got to tame this thing. This could continue. If you look at the time series, it tells me well, this inflation is not going to come down that fast. We're going to have repeats of it. So if you think, hey, we're done here, no. That means we're going to have more adjustments. That means the market has to adjust. Having said that, when you put that in the context of Comrade Putin and the fact that now we at least have some adults in the room, we're not handing over Ukraine over. I think we have an adjustment gun in the market. And with that said, full disclosure, we have some put spreads on our option package has for March expiry. And the strikes are going to freak you out. Make sure you're sitting down. Let me bring a chart up. We're dealing still with econ calendar, but I want to go over that with you right now for full disclosure. We have spreads around here. I'm going to give you exact spreads because that belongs to a pack, option pack. But we have spreads around here, and we've been there since Wednesday. It has already tripled in value. Why? He has not moved out of Ukraine. And the data is only giving more credence to what they want to do. I mean, Kevin Kashkari of Minneapolis and Blort of San Luis said, we got to go full bore. These are Dobbs. Okay. So I don't know. I know there are a couple of conservatives left, like Kaplan of Dallas. There's an interim president there. I don't know what exactly their view would be. But assuming the same blend, and I assuming that there are voting members, I think you should be expecting a 50, at least 50, maybe a 100 basis point quickly. I would. I come from Northrop. We take our losses quickly. Write them down. This is happening here. If you want to start moving, the business wants clarity. The ambiguity is causing more problem. Just execute the plan. You want to do 1%? Boom. Do it as soon as you can. One telephonic, one by March. Is it going to shake the market? Let it shake the market. We've had too much free money. We're at peak America. For what? We all deserve it. The news today, how many, the average price in some areas are becoming $1 million homes. With a Dodd-Frank and no lie loans, who's going to qualify? We'll box ourselves. Got to make it practical. So take some of that hot air out. And here's the other thing. There's 25 million new investors in the marketplace since March 2020 from a PPP money that didn't go to the employees, did not pay salaries or rent. They put it in real estate or stock market. What do you think government sex? Yeah. What do you think Gov sex is going to do about that? That's Goldman Sachs is going to do about that. Or Morgan Stanley and others alike. They're going to suck it out. And the hedge funds too. So to me, today was the sending the sheep to a slaughterhouse, this rally here. It didn't say the Fed is going to not do what they said. It just wasn't that bad. So because the expectation was so low, we had this huge rally. And was I wrong? Absolutely. Down here, I was short on the NQ. Couple of ticks up. Oh, I said, I'm rotating. And I'm playing the guns. You have to. You can't go in on the first crunch big. I've never done that. That's how you get in trouble fast. You in to test the waters. It's not working. You reverse and open. Fall up. Why? Because there's a Momo coming. You can't get long up here. That's too late. You can't wait for it to be sure. So I had one of my most incredible days today. And I was just exhausted too. And of course, early on, that drop we had was Another, let's see, I'm trying to get the time here. Earlier, this shake that we had here, that was a little bit confusing, but look how we dropped down. So, I've been short bias wise, you know, on the market timing. We also have a market timing trade for PMT members that were some of our present here. We're standing by that too. So, we still think our targets are reasonable. If it changes, we'll let you know by email. Okay. So having said that, for full disclosure, let's move on. Oh, I'm sorry. We haven't finished with, economic calendar. So, retail sales came in, industrial production. I mean, these are strong. These are strong. Not an issue. Let's take a look here. There we go. 1.4 versus 4. Yeah, month to month. Look at the employee. You know, we have what, almost 7 million jobs created. We haven't had that in, I don't know, 50 years. Now, again, part of the thing is, so Biden's not the smartest dude in town. No, he's not. Because Biden was better than Democrats. No. Don't get me wrong. That's how he was. Remember, he always had money. No. But the benchmark is too low. Because we were such a disaster before. Yes, the goalpost has changed. So everybody looks like a hero. Except we're not ready for it. That's why we have such high inflation. So we're going from one extreme to another. Just keep that in mind. Jobless claims tomorrow. I'll be watching that. And prior to that would be housing. Okay, this is pretty much in line. There's nothing unusual there, 220. We'll see if it gets any big number. I doubt it. And then, if anything, it's under pressure. But this is what I want to look at. Housing. Yeah, yeah. You can see they're slightly pushing the numbers higher, slightly at the margin. Now, of course, commodity prices have not helped. Existing home sales on Friday. Again, boiler speaking. See that? These guys are out there. This is Mr. Dove Williams from New York Fed, the one who handles all of our debt. He's there. Oh, Mr. Dove himself, Charlie Evans of Chicago. By the way, he follows Admiral Tico on Twitter. My dog. And the existing home sales. Let's see. What do we have there? Yeah, Philly Fed and Chicago follow him. I wish Boyd would do that. Maybe he'll learn something. Anyhow. 6.1 million. Okay. See that? Again. Yeah. And consensus about the same. 300 change. Yeah. We'll see how the real number is going to be. Yeah. And remember, this is expiration. So don't try to trade in the afternoon tomorrow. They're going to pin it, as always they do. This was full month. They do it also with weekly. All they do is 6-7 top names on NDX. You're controlling NQ. Remember, you have only 100 names there. And you have market caps, right? So the Fang M and a couple of more names, boom. And Tesla, you're controlling a NDX, which control because of zero arbitrage rule, you can't have any NQ movements. So I go away. I don't hang around. So I get, now, in exchange for that, I come a little bit early. I come a little bit early because there's always some expression. Remember, it's not future expression. It's cash money. But SPX and NDX are going to, the options on those will expire right in the open. So prior to that, there will be some activity, some positioning. I'll probably be in the 45 minutes early, trade that, and trade maybe a first hour, and then sell that week. And I'm too tired. These weeks are brutal. I have no week. Last week, I had a little bit of time off because it was Super Bowl, and by design. I'm just totally time bankrupt. And I said, don't pay for me. Just send me some of your hours. Okay, tell God to give me like a couple of hours extra. That's all I want. If you guys give in, like, donate 5 minutes of your time, all of them, then I get my extra hour. How's that? We can do that. Okay, thanks. Just kidding. Okay, on change on ES, basically. The trick is that you want to watch this level, crucial. Today was crucial to watch this level. 44.29. I pounded on the desk several times in the chat, so watch that. And we came very close. You see that 68 versus, I mean, we were 40 cents off. Coincidence? Heck no. That was a signal. Remember, the big guns, not me, I'm very small. The big guns cannot send each other. Nobody can send email. That's called collusion. The way we do collusion is by technical analysis. Because most of us have the same schooling, same concepts of what to look for. And the trick is that number, number before. I would really like to see this number taken out, the low of this bar. But you know, notice how it's hanging at 200 day. Yeah. And we're below, that cross is coming. When this happens, number portfolio managers more of a middle of the road, old school. It's in your contract. You have to sell. You can't hold on with names like that that would resemble the index, and you got a death cross coming. That's when the 50 crosses 200. So a lot of ticks are going to sell. And I want that. Why? I want to get some of this fluff out. Plus, I got puts out there. I need some shekels. Tico needs new clothes. Yeah. So, I mean, now, in the meantime, back at the ranch, McDonald's there goes up. Oh, well. You know, a little flat on CI. This was ideal for CI to sell. To sell from this level, you know, the slightly CI negative, CI diff negative, and sell would have been godsend, but we don't have it yet. Volume is not that high, so there's no capitulation. Therefore, there's no bottom yet. Where's the bottom? I need some capitulation. I want baby with bathwater out of the 10th floor. I haven't seen that. We will see that. Remember, March 20th, Spring Equinox, Persian New Year. 2 years ago, when I talked about this time, when I talked about it, no, a little bit after this, that I'd already gone short SPX. Yeah, it was a little bit after this. It was like a week or two from now. But very early, very, very early March. It was a webinar, it's recorded, it's on the website. That said, look for March Equinox, that's a low. Low came on the 22nd Sunday. March Equinox was Friday. So he didn't even get to the next business day. And the target was 18,000 the day Trump got elected. They're going to take him out in the back and teach him a lesson. The hedge guys. This is the guys who hold the masters of this universe are the hedge guys. And look for 18,000 on a Dow. YM printed that night, 18086. Nothing new to you. I've said it many times to you. And I know if you remember that webinar, somebody was asking me, give me the date. I know your target. Give me the date. I said, Jesus Christ, I do price at a new time. And that was a pick out of the air because those two have always worked over the years. If you go back, March Equinox and, Spring Equinox and Fall Equinox work like a charm. I don't know what it is. Somebody tried to explain to me, including Arch Crawford, that it's gravitational force, whatever it is. But we do crazy things. We go out of whack a little bit. So I'm not saying it must. I'm not saying 100% it will, but that's something you want to watch for. So at what's March 20th here? I believe it's a Sunday. Yeah, I think it's Sunday. Because 18 is expiration. Yeah, it's a Sunday. So somewhere around there, plus or minus one day. So either on Friday or that Monday, we're going to have the reversal. That should be our low, tradable low. Now, what else ties to that? I've seen some private work on some time studies, time cycles. I believe 39 days is smack on that day. Boom. So, and this stuff works. If you go back on the 39 days, you'll see it. So, keep those in mind. For the target, I just took that number out. Now, remember, of that option trade, I don't need it to go down. Delta down here is very low. But as you start moving, and remember, it's a long and short. It's a long put and a short put. The combined delta is very low. But as we start moving toward it, let's say we take 4,000 out, this number can explode exponentially. It's like a COVID. It feeds itself. It becomes exponential. So that's what I'm looking for. You know, give me 50X, I'm out of here. The max for that trade, because 200-point spread, is 199 to 1. That's a lot. I'm not expecting to win all of it. Give me some, I'm happy. Right there, already it's 3 to 1. So that means now the odds change. It's 3 to 197 now. Before it was 1 to 199. You can only max what the spread is. Yeah, I got to give credit to Nancy, our Airbus. She helped me put it together. Yeah. I mean, listen, we both hunt for these. You got to look at the pricing. You got to look at the option chains in detail. But she saw it. I saw it. We call back each other on it. On the phone, I said, listen, let's go to our collaborative page on Google and let's put the trade together. And First day, only one guy got in. Next day, a bunch of people got in. And since then, we have people added to the position. Now we'll see. We'll see. You know, we just got to be careful. All positions are still in green. Nothing in the water yet. Like I said, yesterday hit 3-something, 365, so not bad. All right. There is a coal mine. We got to take a closer look here. But you can see transpiration is not doing that hot. As a matter of fact, the peak came a little bit sooner than the Dow, or maybe, yeah, a few days before. It usually does this advanced look. And that's a very unusual day. I've never seen ATH like that, all-time high like that. But usually that is a step function. But it's just, this was a huge one. There's no wrong, nothing wrong with it. They have not corrected it. Nobody has. Every other data, provided I've looked at the values, I'll say. Of course, this drives SPX, the transportation, and Russell drives NDX, or NASDAQ comp. Excuse me. E-trenders. Let's go through that. We're borderline being positive or negative. Looks like a 7 or a negative. Yeah. Which also says we're pressed. Mean reversion says it could come back. But it's not the death cross. It's just the prices versus 50 and 200. But we're just above that on SPX. Everything else is below. We're poised to break down. Whether we will or not, it's the issue of catalyst. So we need to keep watching. There's no guarantee because we're down here, we're going to break down. But we're poised. We're ready to go. You know, so as we say in the Navy, it's armed and fueled on catapult 2. So it's ready to go. On VIX, I had a lot of questions about my prediction of 40 to 50. It jumped across from 4 Sigma. If you go back in history, especially if you go into weekly, you see the shock waves. The shock waves are far more predictable than prices. I don't think we're going to go to 80. I doubt we're going to see 60, but we're going to be right below that. I believe it's going to be 40 to 50. If I go to daily here, 4 Sigma is at 39. But remember, as we go up there, this number is going to move. Just like when we came down a little bit, that number has moved. So threshold would be at least a 40 and something above it to make the low. So just like an M. But remember, this is a negative asset. It's a volatility. So negative correlation to equities. If you see an M here, okay, then we got to go up. Is this the M? I don't know. Remember, we'll know these in the rear mirror. It could be. Could be. It could be that the trade is bad. I'm not going to make any. That's fine. The bet was very small. One guy already took his cost out. So he says, hey, I'm going to ride this baby. I said so much the better. He just sold enough to pay for his inbound. Mistake I did. I didn't do that. I missed that. I could. Greed came in. And he took a little profit. So the rest is all house money. I think, though, all other things being equal, it's impossible for us to head back up. It's more like event-wise. May not be as bad as we thought, but we're going to sell. So take a look at your Bauer stocks, get rid of them. What do I mean by Bauer stocks? I look at stocks only one way. I was student of Jack Shelton at UCLA about on AMC, AGS, the business school there. Like a master's program. Investment grade assets have three parts to them. It's in the annual report, actually. Take a look at it. And he had always told us, reach from the back to forward. Forget the front. That's for the shareholders. You're a financial analyst. you're neutral. Your money is not in it. You don't have a bias. Read it neutral, like a doctor. Be clinical. Reach from the back to the front. It's three places: balance sheet, management, and products. Anything that has any flaw in one of the three, bow off. Why? Because Russell is telling you that. If Russell gets to selling and selling, all these names are going to be in trouble, especially at higher marginal interest rates, because they're not as big as NASDAQ. They don't have, not all of them have access to big public markets. They are in mercy of merchant banks and lenders and so forth. And with Dodd-Frank and all that, that's going to be expensive. So get rid of any borrower stocks while you can. You can't, remember, the theater has a couple of exits only. If somebody fires or yells fire, not everybody's going to be able to get out safe. Think about that concept. Okay, now. Not then. Now. Okay. SP1 Momo. It's doing a little bit better than it did this morning, I might admit. And we were negative about -3. I did not post anything intraday on this, just didn't have the time. But it came back up 0.8. Obviously, I'm going to comment live in the chat. So that's a premium flagship product, obviously. They get the most value. But I didn't get a chance to show them. This chart is available on that platform, too. But I just yelled out what the values were, saying, hey, we were about -3, so we were shooting down at the beginning. Again, the good news was that the Fed minutes, if you read it, my copy came in also. It was mailed out 202 by out of Washington. Mine, I didn't get it to 220, whatever. I didn't have time to read it. I just got heard of it in excerpts. Basically, it was not as bad as we thought. Okay. Now, I just printed out. I'm going to go over it in detail. To me, this January Fed meeting is probably the most important meeting we've ever had in a long, long, long time. Again, why? Because of peak America. Everything is so expensive. And with a Dodd-Frank environment, no live loans, something's have to give. Has to. And you don't wait. You'll get a chance to buy it again better. It's just, I'm warning you, don't go and buy it now. Okay. SQ. Oh, yes. There we go. I rest my case. All this time it was dropping down. I've got a pretty good technical guy, his engineer, very, very smart, went to Harvard, out of LA, telling me, he watches this thing. And of course, he's new at it, so he's trying to get help on the interpretation of it. And all this time, something goes, finally, yes, he was dropping. Because this comes out about an hour at the end of the market. We just got up to here. So this was telling us they're taking some trades off. Well, yeah, because it's kind of dropping like this. When it drops like this, and you have all of the money, put spreads, they're going to explode logarithmically. Logarithmically. Just do the math. It's Black-Scholes model. Well, then we go up, and nothing is happening. Nothing's happening. We actually drop even further. So now he's panicking, like, I don't interpret it. What's going on out there? I said, hold on. They'll find the pairs they need to put on. They'll find the opportunity. It's not easy. Here's the problem. The money's a lot of volume. Keep that in mind. We kind of get squeezed in there. The bigger you are, the tougher those positions are. Because you need to have a sucker on the other side. So you're going to laugh and say, oh, I got these good puts. I'm not worried. The other guys on the side, they say, let's have a beer. Let's chat. Yo, have a champagne. Celebrate that. Well, hold on. Nothing to celebrate. The results are not in yet. But think about the other side. The market makers sing and say, hey, we've got these sheeps out there in Florida. They keep on buying this crap from us. They think they got to make some money off of us. We got to clean them. That's the concept. You got to find somebody on the other side. That back and forth goes until the trade gets sealed. So, but this coming up says what? They're beginning to establish more other money put spread, or puts or put spread. I don't know both, but puts or put spread are being established there, out of the money, and so the tail risk is increasing. Remember, it's not it's a downside tail risk, I should say, not just plain tail risk. Downside, because there's upside tail risk too, which would be up here. People buying calls up. No, right now they're buying puts. Nobody keeps track of that. That's really not crucial because there's no limit. There's a limit down here. It's called zero. So this becomes far more sensitive in terms of emotions. So finally, it's beginning to move up. Good. Now, is it fully ready to go? No. It was up here. Look at that. We went over the design limit of 150. We're about 1.5 sigma there. Okay, so that was good. That was good. Not exactly what I want, but hey, this is not December 2019 where this baby went up. Was it here? Hold on. Analog is always important. Let's see. If you go to December, that's 21. Yeah, we got to go way back. Yeah. Sorry, guys. I shouldn't be taking your time like this. This is 21. No, a year before this. Okay, this sucker went up. Well, I knew something was up. I knew something has to be up. It was March. That's when we dropped. Yeah. Right there. Yeah. Right by my birthday. And people were asking me, "Hey, what's wrong?" I said, "The skew's up." What does that mean? "Oh, that's your gibberish." Yeah, don't worry. I can't talk to a lot of people. They don't understand my gibberish. That's okay. The skew is about 4 sigma. Look what happened. And the window is about a month or two. Look what happened. This was just begin. I think we're just beginning to detect COVID in the U.S. The smart money knew where to park that money. And this skew gives that detection. So I think we have something coming, hopefully. We'll see. Gotta watch it daily. If it starts continue to peak, move forward, I'm in, yeah. So we'll see. We're not even to 1 sigma yet. Remember, measure it against yourself. Always have a sigma channel on. TD, all right. This was incredible yesterday. I've never seen that. Look at the scale. Look at this. I've not seen that before. Not like this. Went from negative 2 to plus 2, crossing 0 line this fast in about what? 1 day? No, 2 days? Yeah, about 2 days. Yeah, it was incredible. Absolutely incredible. Now it's pulled back, a little bit more normal, but not actually negative. To me, this was absolute danger coming. This shows the inversion of the term structure of the volatility. So again, that's also, this is not something they necessarily trade, but they watch this like a hawk. It's a 3 months VIX, and it has to be lead. Okay, so we just, this morning they expired. The February contract for VIX expired this morning. It was trading yesterday, but expired this morning. Now the H is current lead. So this is long H, short M, the June contract. Let me make sure I'm correct. Yeah. Yes. Long March, short June, H and M. That's the spread. And then you put a sigma channel. You can't put regular sigma channel because that is looking for one input. You have to put the spread in there and then you let the spread be measured against itself and its volatility. So it's a vol of the VIX spread. Go figure, right? So remember, financial engineers don't like to measure the derivative of a derivative of a derivative. Yeah, this is one of those. And then we have to build a rule for it. When it gets to here, it says that's a low. Yeah, it was a low. Past 1, not just past 0. It went to 2. It almost was like, I need VIX. That's what happened. I need VIX. Yeah, I need to protect my portfolio badly. That's how that spread was created. And in retrospect, that was low. I don't think that's the end of our story. Here's why. If this is what we're reading this early at this level with the rest of the stuff I've explained, watch for the spread to hit 3-4 easily. That would be our sign. That may be already too late by then. So, all right, SP2, this came back to neutral. It was pointed down up to about like 155 this afternoon. Pointed down, so it was hooked down. The talk I had with some of the people who had those options were, hey, we're looking for the low of yesterday to be taken out, and look how close we came. We did not. And of course, the news came positive. Well, I'm sorry. The news was a relief rally. It wasn't as bad as we thought, kind of economists. But that does not include some of the more recently the other series that have been publicized that were reported. The Fed didn't have it either. And so I would not be surprised for them, if they're any clever, to do an intermeeting rate change. That means that you have no notice. No notice at all. It just come on, flash on the news wire saying 50% is in, and they'll work on another 50%. Partly because he flooded the market. He had to. The Congress wasn't doing anything. Congress was in deep trouble. And the political president, this is March of 2020. Remember, he punched in on March 23rd, 2020. That law I was talking about happened because he punched in. Yeah. Powell said, I have a new product. Recently, he talked about it in a frontline package. Go to frontline, pbs.org, and look at that. That's really saved us. The Congress doesn't have no clue what's going on. And then also, it's a wishy-washy. They get votes, this, that, president has to sign. There was no time. He came in as the ultimate powerful guy, taking a single decision and saved us. Now he's going to take some of that back because he's pumped too much in. Again, that's why everything is so expensive. And it's on the affordability index, and also first-time homebuyers are not there. Why? The back ratios. They got all these BAWA degrees from stupid universities with a lot of loans. So the back ratios are trouble. They can't file bankruptcy. It's not dischargeable. It's a whole slew of things. Then you have Dodd-Frank. You can't lie. We got to adjust. We got to take some of this hot air out. And it'll come. Now, it may not be March, but it's soon. We're on that leg. We're not going to go up until some is hot air thing. At least that's my 2 cents. As Tico says, my 2 shekels. It's from a different tribe. All right, here's another proof right here. Look at the treasuries, and this is the 2-year highs. I'm not punching the 2-year high here. This is way too far. Bro, look at another. This is way too long. This is the IRX, the 91-day discount rate. If you do EBY, economic bond yield, it would be pretty much the same, a little bit higher. But we're over 2 here. And 2.4, this is the 2-year high. We're going to take, this one's already taken it out. It's punching it up 5 years. You remember car loans, house loans, mortgages, and then long-term responsibilities like healthcare and so forth by insurance company backed by Class A buildings that would want this rate in the 30-year, or 40-year loan. You would use off this. We would premium over this rate. So we're beginning to edge up. Also, I don't like the Fed in this market. They have no business being on this long end. They should really control this. But that's how dire states we were. The problem also we have is that the debt, before we put that trade on, we had to come in and, excuse me one sec. Before we put our trade on, we always show the market cap. But we're trading SPX options. So we have to assess the value of SPX. It's not on Google Finance. It's not on Yahoo Finance. You have to dig it in. It's about $42 trillion. Okay? The S&P 500, the 500 best companies in the U.S. because of management, product, and balance sheet. Valued at about $42 trillion as of last Wednesday, right? A week ago. How much we owe? About $30 trillion. So we have pledged 75%. If you think about it, even though there's one is a public debt, the other one is a private asset. But as a whole, as a company, and I mean as a country, we have pledged 75% of our best assets. That's not very smart, is it? Long term. Yes, we've got to adjust the way we do things. This is nuts. Okay. Dire straits in my world. I'm glad I don't have kids. Those of you who have kids and grandkids, watch out. You got to work harder. Yeah, you got to save more for them. It's just that state of affairs. Doesn't mean I'm not aggressive. I was wrong here. I go where the market goes. I block myself out. I look at volume on price. I look at practical. But at the same time, I understand within this context, I've got March 20 low coming. Until that theory is proven wrong, I'm going to hold that view. So, okay, let's go here. Last but not least, here's our... there's one more chart for you guys. I'm going to go Larry's. Okay, here's where we are. This is updated? I don't know. Hold on, I don't think so. One second. Should be fine. Yeah, okay, it just did. Okay. And remember, this, just like SQ, is one an hour after the close. And I don't know if it does update during the day. I really want to count on it. It's meaningless. Really, you got to get close. But yeah, look at the separation between the two moving averages. Huge. See, red and blue right here. It's really huge. That tells me we're probably not going to fill it. Probably the next leg is down, not up. I know it's mean reversion. But every time we open up, there's a continuation of the trend. They cannot catch to it, right? Cannot cross to it. Yeah, if this thing opens up, also remember, it's alarmingly giving us the divergence since this time frame. About April of last year. Yeah. From April of last year, it says that be careful. We don't have the full support of all the names behind us. It is what's happening is that more less and less people, I mean, less and less names are above the 200 day. That means that it's a, the market cap is causing that, you know, the 5, 10 big names, where all the big players are hiding their names. But the average stock out there is not there. Now, I heard and read some names are 50% down, 70% down, you know. There's the undercurrent that's not very good, so keep that in mind. Not good. It's very aggregate stuff. Yeah, and this is where the lows are. This is 2020. All right, let me go here. One more thing I want to go over. That's my baby, by the way. I got 19 of them. We lost two. There we go. This is what I want to talk about. I will also talk about the buying power. Okay, we have recently released this to our expert package, including this chart. So you download and you take this chart and boom, it comes online. What does it do? I like to run it about 30 minutes during the day, 30 minutes more, so I can see the volume ratio. And this is a really good, solid, robust calculation. I'll explain why. Sorry. Unlike the timer chart, up and down volume ratio, which is just simply taking two ratios. This one, it doesn't take the unchanged, because there's also unchanged volume, but it's very small. You have up volume and down volume. But for the up volume, it takes the up volume divided by up plus down as in the denominator. And then reverse on the down volume. So it's a down volume divided by same denominator, up plus down volume. Total values, and now we've added recently also. Person has those time series, you have to make sure that you are permission for those. These. So you can look them up. If you're a part of the package, you get it, we send it to you. If you're not showing one chart, that's because some of these are missing. Either the asset, because Russell is a different animal. They charge it differently. And then you are, then you're up and down volume. Good thing is, I don't think if you're a professional, I'm not charging anything on Russell. But the SPX do. I pay extra on the SPX. The exchanges have figured out to milk us. Okay? That's just reality. What does it mean? We look for 80% plus signals. The red is 90. 280% we'll consider back to back. Not 80 and negative 80. No. 280s or 190. And we have a PDF that we tell you guys to read. That was also on Twitter. We'll send it to you. It's that simple. And we downloaded the work of Paul Desmond, president of Lowry Research, big technical firm in, I believe, Tampa. I forgot. And somewhere in here, okay, what's the name now? Somewhere here I posted it. I said, you know, go and read that. Because there was a question, how do we do this, how do we do that? I'm not the best at it. I know enough to get to be dangerous. I know how to read it, basically, but not all the conditions. Also, what did they do in 2020? I don't know. I was looking at my own chart, which is slightly different than this. Anyhow, it's on our cloud. Oh, I forget where it is here. If you need it, you guys write to me. I'll send you the link. There we go. Best to read the PDF from Paul Desmond, and that's what it is. He'll put it up. It's his work. We're just hosting it because I don't want to keep on sending people and try to find it, and they find the wrong document. They come back, hey, is this the one? I don't even time back up, but it's a good read. It's a very good read. So, and the rules and all that. So, if you're interested to understand market timing and try to be some independent, have some independence in the sense that you have a sense of it yourself in real time, rather than, oh, wait, see what Faggot says, or XYZ or other timers say. This is a pretty good sense of mechanically, by one indicator only so far, say we're overbought, oversold. It's very good for turns. I'm of the school that says one indicator will not do it. You know that. To me, it's a preponderance of evidence. It's a civil case, not a criminal case. One indicator would be criminal case. It's beyond reasonable doubt. There's no such a thing in the market like that. Hey, Dave, how are you? Welcome. Such thing. So, but I would get, depending when we are on it, let me go to daily chart. Here we go. Let me put it this way. This is the way, at minimum, it's my understanding of how it is. Depending when we're on a chart, I'm looking for certain things. If we're up there, like at sigma level, then I'm looking for certain things on the top, especially at SPX. Now, Bo and Walter, they talk about SPX. I just have these two, and finally, so when I look at Russell, because Russell precedes at NASDAQ, and I'm trading NASDAQ. I need that. I did this for selfish reasons. But it's there, and there's nothing extra. All you do is control R, and this baby refreshes, and then I share it with you guys. Now, there's another one I don't have a permission to share with you guys yet, because I didn't write the code. This one is written by Peter Cook, our moderator. He's a very smart cookie. I'll talk to him. Notice where the signals are. And now, this only works on TradeStation because it's data, the type of data that's needed. But some very, very weird data is needed, believe it or not. Again, it's part of what Paul Desmond's done. I have no clue what this stuff is. Also, it's an up value composite. Don't ask me. Don't ask and I won't tell. I have no clue. I'm just a poor dumb immigrant. What the hell do I know about this stuff? But he had the data and he wrote the code. And now, he runs it long only. Okay? Because it's a terrific record. Terrific record. If you traded, he has long only on the system. So you didn't take the shorts. You only took the longs. Terrific, terrific results. Okay. I can't do that. I'm long and short, guys. So, I mean, I don't take sides. I don't care. You know, I just want to pay. You know, I just want to go with the trends. So I activated the short side. I'll talk to him. We're probably going to add this to the expert package also. The key is really these indicators, and you can only do it on TradeStation. I don't know why offering they're doing it, but they're doing it. It's available. And that's discussed another PDF. If we do this, we get that PDF out to you also. Okay? What else can I tell you? That's it for me. Bottom line is I'm moderately short. I'm flexible. Two options. I'm not heavy short. Nor do I want to be. No, that's just not very smart. But as it starts progressing toward that, it starts breaking down, then I'll get more aggressive. I'll maybe put additional options on. We have an option on the PBT on. Let me say PMT on. We're going to do that. Oh, one more comment. The PMT week has not arrived. Remember infrastructure week? You wait for that 4 years during the Trumpian world we were in. Well, we're in the PMT world right now. We're in ORB world, the opening range breakout. Hasn't given me a chance. But we'll get. I mean, we are active on TFT. We just haven't fixed it on time. We will get to that. We just fixed another issue we had on the returning members. We're inundated, so I'll get to that. Let me get the 4-3 certified and out. Let me get the gamma ladder finished. We're close. Remember, I don't do it myself, but I work very closely with this very smart fellow. But we're in a place where I think probably realistically March 1st, I'm going to be a realistic commitment there. I can get started on the cleaning the PMT archive. Okay. We just have to include it in the archive in the newsletter and get over some issues or there's no change in it because the machine copies it every Friday night as a preservation mode. We just have to delete some that we don't need it. There was no change. And then we have to insert our emails to Time and Digest, which you guys got too. I may come to you guys and say, hey, can you look at this time frame? Because I have the worksheet. There should be an email I'm missing. Why? Because twice we upgraded our email service. But Nancy has it, others have it. But just to prove, we just have to put those in. That's it. There's nothing else there. So. Okay, any questions for me? I'd be more than happy to look at any stock you want or something. I'll be more than happy to. It's only 6:10, 6:14. I'll be here another 15 minutes if you like, if you have questions. Or any questions about any of these charts? Everybody's awake. When I didn't put you guys to sleep today. I hear nothing. Is audio good? Okay. Three, you're quite welcome. Any questions? Okay. Remember, these all go get post-processed here. Go to our page on YouTube. Okay. We have about 1,300 people there, a subscriber. Best is to subscribe. This way, the moment you get posted, you get alerted. I'm sorry, 5,000? 5,000? Is your 5,000? Oh, you mean, no. You mean projection, 5,500. Yeah. No, it's not. We got to see 5,500. By year, right? We got to do a flush first. Actually, the faster we do the flush, the better we have a chance to go up there. Obviously, along the way, good question, Michael. I'm sorry, you got me out. We got to take 4,800 out. Now, it's a binary situation, too. If we go to 4,800 now, probably not going to go down. I doubt that. There isn't that good of good news here right now to go up. The news is stacked against us on the downside. But no, I'm not canceling 5,500, no. But first, we got to go through 4,800. And we can always do a V-bottom. So it's possible we can come back hard. But we got to get that flush out of the way. And Fed, give us a couple more raises. Let's say this. Let's think about it this way. One scenario could be we get between now and June all the interest rate raises, and we will go to this level and blah, 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 blah. And maybe we do actually see 3,300. Frankly, I've seen SPX at, there we go, at weekly. It's not easy. It takes a lot to go down there. We've been there. It's not wild imagination. It is not. While 200-day daily is often kicked. The weekly is not that easy, but it has happened. But let's say we flush down there to June. So we don't do dribble, like a little needle in your arm. When I was a kid, they used to give me B12 shots. And usually it takes 30 minutes. You can't have it too fast because your heart and your neck get warm up. You can't do that. If they give it fast to us, yeah. Then we could clear and, yeah, you're going to see capitulation. You're going to see baby with bathwater on the 10th floor, left and right, New York, Chicago, everywhere. Once all the babies are out of the windows, they'll be fine. And then you gotta, then you're gonna be ripping people's faces. That short recovery is gonna be so fast, you haven't seen. Then we have a chance to go up. Go up and yeah, 5,500 done. I cannot assess for you right now that it's gonna be definitely this year, but it could be very close. Yeah. But first target, after that kind of a drop, would be 4,800. We have to take that out. Do you track ORBD Wednesday even though system? Oh, what do you mean ORBD? You mean ORBCV, right? You mean our system? Dennis? You mean the opening range channel breakout? Yeah. Yes, yes, opening. Yeah. No, there is no signal. No, we do track it, not publicly. We do it for backtest. Yeah. We can individually go and turn it off and on. Yes. Yes, we can. And we do it because we turn it off. Okay. When do you want to turn it back on? When do we do that? We got to run it. Yeah, you got to turn it back on. Yeah. Run it and say, okay, guys, moving forward, we're going to turn it back on. Right now, the net result, that's a question Dennis is asking. It's a very good question. Let me get to a little bit more detail for the novice. ORBD stands for, ORBO stands for, actually should be ORCBO, opening range channel breakout. Okay. That's the name of our system. We're running 4.2. On 4.1, we noticed that we're having troubles on Wednesdays. So when we went to 4.2, we turn off. Why? Because we have an input on the version I run, not the version that we give to folks to run on the tracers. Is that what day of the week should trade? We can do individually or only Mondays, only Fridays. Those are give the best results. But as you go to the center of the week, it's just the way the calendar is, it gets less and less. So tomorrow I expect some movement. Friday's going to be good. Monday is going to be great. Tuesday is going to be a little bit less. Wednesday is usually had a series of losses. So one way to keep your P&L up is not to trade it. Now, that condition could change because of volatility, chart patterns, exogenous news. All that could happen. Once we begin to see that, yeah, we can turn it back on. That's possible. Absolutely. Great question, though. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't catch that in the beginning. It's been a long week. Yeah. Because future, no, we do have charts on future too. I'm only sure you can't because of this venue, Frank. No, we run something on futures, but futures have noise in it. You cannot move SPX that easily. Yeah, ES and futures have a lot of noise. Yes, yeah, exactly. Especially for targets, the levels and all that, I write on SPX. Yeah. So you're right, you're on the right track. Yeah. Yeah. And then when we have futures webinars, then you see all futures charts. Yeah. This is a different environment. This is market time. You know, markets don't go by futures. They go by cash. Antonio, yes, sir. What's the margin that you're requiring for ORB system? It's three contracts and it's 14,000 currently. If you go to... TradeStation, okay, as an example, because they're all the same. They're just following what the Fed is doing. Here's your initial, okay? So if you're trading NQ, there's the NQ. The 16.5 overnight. Day trade is one quarter. So 16.5 divided by 4, okay, 16.5 divided by 4. It's 40,125 multiplied by 3. It's 12,375. That's the three NQs during the day. Actually, that's even better. The yield is even better than that. Murray, you miscalculated that, Murray. What is wrong with you? Thank you, Antonio. I'm gonna send you a polo shirt. Good man. Yeah, because when we did this, okay, this was summertime. It was 14, this was 18 and change. So in my mind, I'm keeping saying 14,000. Actually, your margin is 12,300. Okay, now, one more thing though. You have a drawdown. that first month or two, let me go back here. And that, that's crucial to stay in the game. People walk out early, and that's the problem. Here's what I'm talking about, this one, right there. That early part, you need a buffer. So it's 12,000 plus the buffer. Once it goes, it goes. Remember, we're going to have, like right now, we're tracking down a little bit. That's what our market is. You got to understand that. We go two or three bars, I mean, days in a row, four bars, boom, trouble. And then, big one. Not as big as we want, but it's a good one. And there are times like, look at those runners. Market has all kinds of textures. It's not going to show their hands. It's a function of volatility, news, econ data, and also earnings. Earnings. So as this thing moves, you have a lot more buffer. It's much easier to trade with house money than your own. So it's a 12,000 for three contracts. Now, plus the buffer. Buffer, I'm expecting around on this system has been pretty much, except this recently pulling this back a little bit. It's been around $9,000 for the contract. So $8,000 to $9,000. So let's say with 12, we got 20. Now, if you're starting, you should be trading M&Q, which we want that. So three M&Q contracts would be cost you to the 2,000, let me say 1,200 plus, let's say another $800 buffer. Yeah. So that you don't get busted. Now, I'll be up front with you. My brother, he's in the hard ends. He's got all the money in the world. You know, he's the one with the patent to BPA. He opened the account with TradeStation for $2,500. I said, Corey, why? He goes, well, let's see how good your system is. Just because you're my brother doesn't mean it's good. I got to test it. So I'm going to put in two, so I can go through six contracts, okay, plus the margin. I mean, the buffer. The buffer plus six contracts. So I said, well, how are you going to do the buffer? That's 1,200 times two. Plus, the second three are my buffer first. The moment starts getting up and I'm not going, the equity curve itself, QM, is going up and up. I'll convert the buffer into the other three. So I'll be trading six contracts. What happens after that, Corey? Oh, I can write a check. You know, it's just such a type of one, you know. My family is very tight. You know? I mean, my sister runs 700 hotels. Try to get a check out of her for like $1,000. Good luck. Not me, not you. Just, I mean, contractor, whatever. Just, yeah, she's just very tight. All these people are very tight. Remember, they came out of Iran. They came out of revolution. They were in Iran, stuck in the revolution. And they kicked. But I was here. I was going to school. I mean, I was at North by the time. But these guys came out of Iran with a ship on their back. It's worse than Dust Bowls here or World War II here. Yeah. Yeah, just very tight. So he's just doing it with that. $2,500. He can easily put in 40K. Not to worry about it. But I don't want to get involved like that. I want the system to prove itself. So it's trading M&Q, three contracts, decided to go to six. I'm sure by the time you get to 9 or 12, then the guy said, why am I doing that? Remember, well, your commissions are pretty much same price. So it's cheaper to trade NQ, commission-wise. He just doesn't want to risk the money, the downside. Yeah, I understand. So the moment he gets to, let's say, nine contracts or 12 M&Qs, he'll switch to NQ. Then we'll trade three of them. That would actually be bigger. Because three NQs is 30 M&Q. So it's cheaper. Any other questions for me? By the way, we're going to do a webinar on 443. We have to. We haven't done a webinar on that for a while. The last webinar on the system we did was in, let's see, where was it? November 10th. There's a webinar. This is an open area, by the way. We got to do one. The problem is that we've gone through too many changes. Yeah. That were crucial, that were needed. And so that's it. We're going to do one. I'd say this week, coming week, possible. This week, if not, either 22nd or 1st of March, we're going to do a webinar. That will be for the members only, for 4.3. Let's see how many people sign up, what kind of, how crazy it is. We'll be able, we'll invite those who had free trial. So I think so, coming here. You can't have, you can't just invite people who drive from outside. They get lost and I'm getting bombarded with too many questions. But we'll do that. And we remember, we tape everything live. It becomes part of our learning library of videos. There's no time anymore to do one-on-ones. And it protects you and protects me. Now it's recorded. It complies with CFTC, SEC. One last request. Some of you guys are coming to the chat room. Please, last time I'm asking, no initials. Please use your first and last name. Okay? So that we, you keep us compliant. I don't make the rules. Okay? You got a problem with the rules? Write to your senator. But we have to stay compliant with SEC, CFTC. Otherwise, I have to ask you to leave. That's the point. So please do that. Anything else? And NDA. I need your NDAs, guys. Make sure I have your NDA. When you log in, okay, certain packages, Happy Experts, there are different NDAs. If you go in and log in, it's a mind you. We need your NDA. Huh? You guys said that NDA in. Oh, this should say Happy. I got to change that. The name is different. Yeah. Same file. You need an NDA. If you go to Expert, Pro Indicators on Expert, there is an NDA there. Pro Expert needs the NDA. Please print it out, sign it, and send it in. Otherwise, you're not in compliance with our requirements here. Thank you. Anything else? Can the unit size be increased or decreased, whatever user wants to? What are you talking about? I'm not a mind reader, Frank. You're smart. You're a Roman. I'm not a Roman. Which package are we talking about? You're talking about the NQs? The system runs on 3. If you run the system on your end, you can have a 3 or 6. It's a different price for 6 on NQ. But an equivalent to MNQ, so we'd have 3 to 6, 3 or 6, or 30 to 60 on MNQ. So I don't recommend anybody going to 6 right now. But that's locked from inside. Yeah. Why? You want to make some money first. You don't understand it. If you're new, yeah, it's going to be. It's risky. I wouldn't want to go in there. Remember, the downside of a 3 is about 4,000, $2,400 each side. No, a little bit more. Yeah, it could get like to 20 to 4,800. Okay, imagine you doubled that, so 10 grand. Yeah, I don't want you to go. It's not easy to lose 10 grand on your system, you'll never come back. Yeah, you gotta get there. What changes will we be making ORB? It's explained in the documentation, as you know. It's an extra robustness we've added. Very good question, Antonio. If you go to user guide, you see, it says that. Now we have one that says 4.3. We've added this. Each user, each update will have this in there. It tells you exactly what we have changed. And yeah, makes it more robust. It makes the second exit, the second long exit, not a stop, but second long exit. With better trading stuff. It's not what you make, it's what you keep, right? So it improves that. By the way, we were gonna have continuous updates along the way. Why? Markets are not gonna stay constant and software can only improve. So little by little, it'll be less and less. They're not gonna be big, but there'll be minutia a little bit here and there. And we're gonna be testing it and move forward. Remember, my goal is to get the other part. The DMZ part, DMZ plus ATR. And the part of that is what we've done with the gamma ladder. I'll tell you something. Hey, CMI, how are you? The gamma ladder is big for us. It's huge. I mean, if you're running multiple accounts and it's futures that fast, this allows us to point, shoot, and forget. It's basically a standoff weapon. It's like coming with B2, just going out. Let's say you can fly around the dome. The Chrome Dome, you're familiar, anybody familiar with the Chrome Dome mission? If you fly in an Arctic Circle, And at certain points, you launch a cruise missile. It knows the target that goes. Point, shoot, and forget. Well, without getting into the middle of the battle with yourself. The whole concept is coming from Chrome Dome mission. With a stand-up weapon. For flying Chrome Dome mission with stand-up weapon. Hey, I work on B2 bomb. Doesn't I still have nightmares? Yeah. Which I build here. You know what that does? That's the end of the world. Thermonuclear delivery device. Yeah, so it gets to you sometimes. Yes. Yeah. You sending Tico tweets? He's blonde. He's very finicky. I'm not sure he'll accept. You should see what trouble all the girls have with him. Trying to give him some treat. Yeah, he turns them down. So, and you're not even blonde. Yes. I wouldn't go there, Frank. Italian treats. Yes, well, he's Roman. He's half Chihuahua, half Italian Greyhound. And he lives in Naples. You can't get more Roman than that. Anything else, guys? I want to go have a cigar. It's been a long day. So again, Siamak, 1 second. Please watch the video here. I think you got in here probably late. Please, I know you heard my commentary about the market here. What happened with the FOMC minutes? This was just not as bad as they thought. Nothing has changed. So I'm still negatively positioned in terms of mentally on the SPX move. Yeah. And this is 30 minutes. So let's come back here. I want to see this low taken out. We got very close to it. We came 40 cents of taking that out. Now I want this low to be taken out. If we take this low out, and we're going to see it probably a day or two. The issue is what's the catalyst. And then that's it. Boom, boom. You're going to see this level go, that level go. We go. And my hope is the Fed wakes up and do it faster. There'll be less pain if they do it faster. All right, guys. With that, I bid you guys farewell. As you know, this is going to get post-processed. I'll be posted on the YouTube channel. Make sure you subscribe. It's a lot easier because I don't know what will get posted. Depends on the post-processing. Yeah, this was a long part. And I want to take a break. When I come back, I'll post it for you. And we'll also send you email and all that, but much better. The moment it's posted, as a matter of fact, when I launch it for the post, it's got a little timer there. As it gets close to like 100%, it sends you a note saying it's ready to go. By the time you come in, it's ready to watch. Okay? Thank you, guys. Stay safe. Be careful. Thank you, Dennis. Appreciate that. Please be careful of your capital, of risk capital. We have some shakes coming forward. It won't be nice. It won't be like the go-go days we've had last few years. Please be respectful of that, okay? You know, if you want to experiment, make it very simple. Don't go crazy because there's going to be a good trade coming and you don't have the capital. Always happens to me. I'm telling myself out loud what I'm telling you. It gets to those points. So be careful, okay? Thanks. Or Ralph, the elite package, I just want to make sure you're aware of. Lou, the elite package will be next week. We've got to get the 4-3 here first properly. Okay. See you guys. Thank you, Antonio. Send me your address. I'll get you a polo shirt. And then your size, okay? HA polo shirt. We don't sell them. You get it as a point of gratitude because of your contributions. Appreciate that. So. Good night.